I think this is really helpful, not only while jumping, but in life. Greetings from Mexico. That's an awesome question.
That is a fantastic question.
Yeah!
Ding, ding, ding. Question of the day.
Julio! What's up, players? What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to episode...
Six
of Ask the Zen Dudes, not even waiting for it, getting right into it. I do want to just make one short comment about, it's really cool to like, to have started this and see how many people ask questions. And all I'm trying to say is we really like making this show for you guys, and we try to be as helpful as possible while entertaining you at the same time. So keep the questions coming. That's all we got to say.
You know what, man? That was my biggest beef about a lot of school, like traditional school that I went to, is like, you go there and you have to sit down and like you have to be really serious, and then you don't really get to ask that many questions, just getting talked at most of the time. And so I like this. This is my favorite way to learn. It's like you guys ask questions and we f around and answer them, actually answer them correctly, but make it interesting.
Actually, now that you say that, my most fulfilling college classes that I remember were lectures where the professor literally had like no agenda. They were just like experts in one topic. Like my Russian studies teacher was a brilliant Russian guy from Russia. And like he would just stand up there and we would just ask him questions about the material that we read. And like I learned so much from that.
Yeah, and you get to the class discussions, AKA you guys in the comments.
Question number one. Diego, my man, how you doing? Is it true that eating fast any of your meals increases the chance of gaining weight? If so, how do you eat slower? Brandon, go ahead.
All right, my man. I think Diego, you know this, but we're gonna reiterate this again.
If that's the case, we would be real fat.
Here's the deal. Really, I know there are probably articles about this, and you probably read this somewhere, and so maybe there's some kind of legitimacy to it. I can't answer that question directly, but I will tell you that this is one of these lower level things you don't want to prioritize as things you focus on. Just focus on eating the right amount of calories and macronutrients, and if you can eat slower, do it, but like that shouldn't be something you stress about.
I totally agree with Brandon, because there might actually be, like, eating meals faster might make you gain weight, but the amount that you would gain or that they've seen done in these studies is so tiny, like, so acute, that it doesn't make sense for you to stress, like, use headspace to stress about it. You should always be stressing about, am I eating the right amount of calories and macros? That's the number one thing that is not going to change.
Yeah, I mean, think about those hot dog eating champions. Those guys are pretty skinny and they eat really fast.
That's a great point. Dude, Kobayashi's like crazy skinny now.
Shredded, six-pack. So,
although, have you seen him lately?
Is he gaining some weight?
Dude, he's crazy skinny.
Oh, really?
Like really skinny, yeah. Mm. It's like not good.
Well, the Zen dudes eat really fast.
That's true.
We are the fastest eater at all dinner tables.
Turkey.
All the time.
Turkey. Jason. How do you get someone to work out with you without sounding mean? That is a good question.
Just invite them to work out, because it should be a pretty normal activity. I don't think you should be like, hey man, listen, like you've kind of put on some weight lately. You should probably get the gym with me. Just be like, yo bro, I'm hitting the gym. Do you want
to
go?
That's so true. It doesn't have to be like something. It can just be like, hey, do you want to go do this activity? You can also trick people into exercising. Like, hey, do you want to go throw the frisbee with me? And then you get there and you start running around and then you force them to run around.
Yeah, and they start breathing all heavy. They're like, hey, I didn't sign up for a workout. And you say, hey, shut the fuck up.
Caleb asks, as I lose weight, should I progressively be modifying my caloric and macro goals?
My friend, yes, we say every 5 to 10 pounds, more or less, you can start to adjust your calories and macronutrients, because the calculator that we have within the dojo, when you put your numbers in there, it's going to give you different calories and macronutrients depending on your weight. So if your weight changes, the numbers are going to change. So every 5 to 10 pounds, don't stress about it too much, but every 5 to 10 pounds. Every 5 to 10 pounds, every 5 to 10 pounds.
Boom. Christopher asks, strategies for curbing your dirty food desires. Your dirty food desires.
Man, you know we ain't got no dirty foods. What do you mean? You dropping food on the floor?
Yeah.
You lint on it?
Man, you eating dirty food?
You eating food with bugs on it? Man, I know you're talking about cake and pizza and things like that. Understand priority number one, calories and macronutrients. Eat the foods you enjoy. It's going to be harder to eat a whole pizza and make it fit your numbers, so... The thing is, man, if you're talking about overeating in general, you just gotta do the thing, brother.
Just stick to your calories and macros. One thing I will add to that, what helped me out a lot, believe it or not, meditation. Because what meditation does is basically slows down your thought process. So when you're like, when I'm in a state of like, after I've meditated, I'm much more calm and can like collect my thoughts and do things at a slower pace. So I found for me, when I started doing this, when I was meditating, that actually helped me curb my food desires, because I would be like, I would get a temptation to want some cake, but my mind would be like, damn, take a step back. Do you want the cake? Do you need the cake? And I'd be like, you know what, cake? You.
Yeah, cake.
I'm just kidding. I would just say, no, thank you.
That's mindfulness, huh? Just practice a little bit of mindfulness.
That's just mindfulness.
Mindfulness.
Sadhu asks, breathing tips while you are doing the thing. Great question.
Yeah. So, man, I think the biggest thing is that you're breathing deeply and you're not, you know, having shallow breaths like in your chest. I personally try to breathe through my stomach, and I know Dan does like a rhythm he'll tell you probably about in a second, but for me, I do like a boxing type breathing. So like, I breathe in through my nose and I kind of spit out my breath, so I go, and it's kind of a weird thing, but I learned it from my boxing coach and it helps me keep my wind. And I think you have to find out what works for you, because Dan, you can tell them what you do, man. It's a little bit different.
I do the typical, you've probably heard this on like every jogging or running blog, the typical breathe to five, count the breaths in, blow out. So into the nose, out through the mouth, count to five, and just repeat that. At a moderate pace. You don't want to be freaking out and like hyperventilating. Jamie, I like this question. Jamie asks, tips and tricks for eating while on the go. I'm in a car for 8 to 12 hours a day with clients, busy working, dude. And I don't have time for sit-down places like Chipotle. What would the Zen dudes be eating? Go.
What would the Zen dudes be eating? Man, I would just carry around some jerky in the car with me. I'd make some dank smoothies using whey protein by Athletic Greens.
Yeah,
maybe make some hard-boiled eggs for the road. Those are always fun. But you'll be farting a lot with your clients, so there's that to think about.
Gotta be careful.
Dude. What are some great Zen dude proof? You know what we should do? We should link him with the Zen dude's 10 best foods of 2016.
Or how to hit your macros on the road.
That's a great one.
Yeah. That one, I'm going to link you to that. Also, hold on a second, bro. What do you mean I don't have time to stop and sit down at places like sit down like Chipotle? Chipotle and sit down, bro. Come on. This for me, my answer is this is totally a mindset thing. This is you being in the mindset that healthy food does not exist in a fast form. That is not true, my friend. If you go to Chipotle, which is totally doable, I do that a lot when I'm in the US. You can get a salad with tons of nutrients, and they have to-go things, man. Like, you can eat that in the car. You don't need to stop at McDonald's and be like, oh man, I guess I gotta get this kind of fast food. There is numerous places when you're driving around. Qdoba is another one. Dude, there's salad places. Chopped, if you have that in your state. Or wherever you live. Guys, the thing I want to stress here is that I don't think it's an okay, and Jamie, this is not directly at you, I don't think it's an okay excuse anymore that people say, I can't get a healthy meal on the road, because there's simply too many options, especially if you live in the United States.
Oh,
they're all over the place. Like, there's grocery stores everywhere that sell healthy salads in there, or have a salad bar inside of it. There's, like I said, Chipotle.
Pull out Yelp and just type in Mexican food.
Mexican food,
and see the closest one. If you're in the US, there is gonna be a Mexican restaurant within like 4 miles of you, no matter where you are.
Yeah.
So get yourself some beans, some rice, some chicken, some avocado. I'll throw that in there for you, a little bowl.
Delis too, if you're on the go and you just want like a big sandwich, you can ask for like double protein and just have a nice big like turkey bacon sandwich.
Damn it, man, I'm getting hungry.
I know, shoot, I'm trying to eat.
Hopefully it helps, Jamie, man.
Yeah, because I think you're in the right, like it's a great question. I think that it really is a mindset thing, though, and I think in this day and age, there is now a bunch of healthy options if you just use Yelp, just search it. Valerie asks, carbs or net carbs? Need to know. Valerie, thank you. You asked this on the last one. Thanks for posting it again.
Carbs and net carbs, need to know. Listen, just figure out your carbs in general and don't worry about doing any of the complicated math of subtracting fiber, sugar, alcohols, things like that. Just think carbs are carbs.
Original carbs. If you see people working out with really bad form, do you guys say anything? And if yes, how do you go about it? Me, I mind my own biz. Go ahead, dude.
Yo, man, I mind my own business because I'm a Zen dude, and Zen dudes just do themselves. They just focus on the present moment, what they're doing. They're fully immersed. That's my recommendation.
Dude, there is nothing more annoying than someone coming up to you and saying like, hey man, I really think you could do, even if they're well-intentioned. Yeah, dude, that really annoys me. So therefore, no, I do not do it to other people because they're on their own fitness journey, just like people who are trying to lose weight. And it's not my place to step in and be like, hey man, I think you could like tweak your elbow a little bit. You're not really doing it right.
Ain't my business.
Yeah, frankly, I just hate people that do that.
So, ain't my business.
If you're one of those people who do that, why don't you just do your own thing?
Okay.
Do you. Yeah. And if someone comes to you and asks for help, if they come to you and ask for help, do we help them? Man, absolutely. All the time. But only when they come to us and have a need. Now, if you also see someone dying, like their form is so bad because they have 800 pounds on the squat rack and they're being crushed, then you can step in.
Save your life.
And call 911 and be like, yo, there's this dude getting smashed by a squat bar. There's blood everywhere.
Hey, I'd like to take a moment and thank our sponsors for sponsoring our show.
Thank you.
Athletic Greens. Takes 27 seconds a day to ensure you have an optimum nutrition. You have optimum nutrition.
Yeah.
Includes, it's flavored by papaya, broccoli, cherry powder, carrot. Do I need anything saying?
Guys, it's really good for you. Tons of nutrients. We take it every single day. And it's the best tasting green juice powder, so check it out. Honestly, between all these supplements, I would rank mine, and I do take protein every day. I sometimes take BCAAs, not as frequently and as important as I think those two are, but that's just me. And we also have cross rope, the jump ropes we always use. They're the best, linked up below.
10% off.
10% ZDF off.
Bundles.
Yeah.
Bundles, motherfucker.
Julio asks, how to deal with the let go thinking that you guys told us in video one for having fun while jumping rope? I mean, how do you switch, damn, I screwed this trick up, unquotes, to, quote, okay, one more time, keep going, unquote. I think this is really helpful, not only while jumping, but in life. Greetings from Mexico. That's an awesome question.
That is Julio. A fantastic question.
Yeah!
Ding, 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 question of the day.
Julio!
Listen, we're humans, so we go through the same thing where we're messing up trying to learn how to do other things, where we're like, you know you want to feel enlightened and be like, hey, you know what, let me just give this another shot. But sometimes it's okay too to be like, yo, this thing, I'm gonna keep going until I figure it out. I can't do this trick. I'm gonna do the crisscross for another 12 hours straight. And that's okay too. You know, sometimes you can take the mindset of like, hey, let's have fun with this. Other times it's fun to like play the let me put my head down and get after this game.
Yeah, just enjoy the process. Like, you're not gonna get better by not doing it. So just do it, bro. Believe in you. Francis asks, is it a good idea to still do the thing when you're sick? Oh, sneaking that second question in, Francis. You're lucky, we love you. Athletic Greens BCAA says to take 16 capsules a day. Is that what you guys do? Go.
All right, first question, is it good to you still to do the thing when you're sick? Listen to your body. Sometimes if I feel really sick, I'm not gonna exercise. If I know I'm coming off of being sick, then you know I might go move my body a little bit, sweat a little bit, but I always listen to my body, and my intensity is really predicated on how I'm feeling that day. If I'm feeling broken down, I'm not gonna kill myself. I'm gonna wait until I feel better so I can, you know, kill myself later. Second question, BCAAs. I take, on average, I take like a third of the serving in the morning when I'm fasted, and then like another third of the serving, so like five or six of the capsules in the morning, five or six before I work out. That's what my dosage looks like.
Agree with everything Brandon said about being sick. Me personally, for BCAAs, I'm just gonna be straight up with you guys. Two things. First of all, 16 capsules is not a ton. A lot of people comment and say, oh, that's so many. It's exactly the same amount as you would take with the scoops. It's in capsule form. So in terms of the serving size, guys, it is the same as taking the powders, but it's in pill form. Having said that, whenever I take BCAAs, which is about 4 days per week, I usually only take eight, four in the morning, four in the afternoon. Honestly, it's because I forget to take the other eight. There's no other reason. Scott asks, general take on proper hydration.
My dude.
Tell him.
Water over everything.
Drink. Water. Half your body weight in ounces of water every single day.
Every single day.
Gotta do it.
In the list of priorities, it's like you need air, number one, so keep breathing. Keep breathing.
Keep breathing.
Number two is water, and then after that, it's food. So before you even start thinking about food, get your water on point.
Yep. Tiffany asks, what is the difference between a forward lunge and a reverse lunge? Does it work different muscles? I think it's the same muscles, but they activate at different times. Yeah. For example, when you put your foot down for the forward lunge, and you plant your heel and then push back, you're activating your glute on like the initial part of the lunge.
Yep.
Whereas the back lunge, you're activating your glute when you go to pull your leg back up.
They're both great.
Yeah, and also it's a balance thing. I would say the difference, the biggest difference is like, I know a lot of people who can do a forward lunge really easily, but they can't do a back. So more than anything, it's like core strengthening because of balance. Ace asks, my cardio is not strong enough to finish all three sets of the 4-week challenge yet. Should I keep going at the same intensity and stop when I can't go on anymore, even if it means cutting the workout short, or should I just ease up on the intensity and or lengthen the rests in between exercises set to make sure? We've never been asked that.
That's Dude, great. That's a great question.
That's a great question.
I say go all out with your effort. That's my personal philosophy in these things. When I'm trying to get stronger, when I'm trying to improve my cardio, I just go as hard as I can for as long as I can, and then you're gonna hit that wall, and that's okay. When you hit it, be like, all right, next time I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna throw one more circuit on this, or you know, give me say next week I'm gonna throw another circuit on this, and that's how I build up fast you.
Yeah, R.I.P. Biggie.
Oh,
that's him, but it's a skeleton. Just be intense, because honestly, your aerobic capacity is gonna increase too, allowing you to go for longer and longer. So there's nothing bad that's gonna come about from just being as intense as possible. Ben, in multiple videos, it's been stated many times that jumping rope when done correctly is better than jogging, but that was never elaborated on. So how is jumping rope when done correctly better than jogging?
Oh, Ben, it just burns more calories, man. We made a video
called... Give me a break. No, I'm kidding, Ben.
Burn 1,074 calories an hour jumping rope. It's because there's been some studies done looking at how many calories are burnt on like an average jump rope workout. And it's just the number one exercise for burning calories. And when you bring in a weighted rope on top of that, you increase the resistance even more, like this bad boy, game over.
Also, I think it's important to mention... we're saying it's better than jogging for the goal that we're trying to create. Mm. If your goal is to be able to run a marathon, then running would be better, obviously. If your goal is to be super lean and ripped and live a super like long life and have like a healthy, very healthy body, running is good for that. Jump rope is better because it is a total body workout, especially in terms of getting the body that like lean boxer soccer player look. You don't have any resistance when you're running. There's none there. So jump rope just simply burns more calories. It's more efficient. And let's be real, it's more fun.
And gets you more.
Yeah. Jail asks, can jumping rope help a person build self-confidence or have high self-esteem?
Absolutely. And I'll tell you why. When you commit yourself to getting better at anything in life, that bleeds into your whole being as a human. It doesn't matter if you're trying to get really good at jumping rope or learning a new language or becoming a mathlete. I don't care what it is. When you go after something with hard intensity to get better, you feel better about yourself because you feel like you have more self-worth.
Yes, exactly. And I think just overall, a lot of movement helps to just make you feel better in general, which
on the chemicals.
Yeah, to snowball into like having more confidence, more self-esteem, feeling better because you're taking care of yourself, you look better. It's all together. It's all
brain together. Chemistry.
My friend.
Serotonin. Dopamine.
Serotonin.
Norepinephrine.
Dylan asks, have you guys ever struggled with the work, fitness, balance? What mindset do you have to find equilibrium if that ever was a struggle? What's up, Dylan?
What's up, D? Man, I've never really had an issue with like work, fitness, balance, because for me, my number one way to relieve stress is by exercising. So for me, it's like medicine, and it's honestly always been that way. I understand not everyone is that way, but that's, I can only speak from my experience. That's what it is.
Literally, the reason I'm sitting here today is because I used to struggle with work and fitness balance. I started jumping rope because I was working all the time at my old corporate job, and I was like, man, I don't have motivation to go do this, nor do I want to go spend 2.5 hours in the gym. Like, why am I doing this? So I picked up the jump rope at first because it was fun and because I was a little bit more lazy and wanted a more efficient workout so I didn't have to exercise as long. So I was like, dude, if I'm just going to get intense and get after it, that's what's going to, you know, provide me the best result. So with the work fitness balance, here's the one thing I'll leave you with. You are always... Brandon and I are always, even though we like, you know, this is our life now, like working out is kind of our life now, we always are working at the same time. Like, you have to put it into your mind that there's going to be no struggle. It's a part of your life. You do it for at least 30 minutes every day. That's it.
Non-negotiable.
Non-negotiable, because it's going to make you better at work, man. It's going to make you like more of a baller at work, dude. Vince asks, Zendu Bradath, Are you guys religious or at least have a religion?
My dad's side of the family is Jewish. My mom's side of the family, kind of Christian. Some people don't really care. And so for me growing up, I got to choose what I wanted to believe in. And although I believe in something greater than me, I don't think it's a bearded man in the sky. I believe it's something that I can't even fully comprehend.
You think it's Santa?
Santa?
Santa!
But yeah, I believe in something greater than me. I believe in something that I don't understand that is having some kind of effect on the world I live in my life and the energies that interplay. But I don't know what that is. I feel like it'd be kind of presumptuous of me to say I know what that is. So that's how I'm gonna answer that question.
Yeah, I'm not like, I don't want to like offend anyone, but I'm not personally religious because I just believe that, I believe in a higher being, just like Brandon said. But in terms of religion, I feel like all religions are kind of saying the same thing and are all promoting this idea of a higher being and better place. So what's frustrating with religions, man, is like, I just don't understand why we can't all get along and just be together as one in this world. I honestly don't mean that in a cheesy way. That's actually the way I feel.
Yeah, we all want the same thing. We want to be loved and we want to be taken care of. And like, that's what a lot of religions say. But then like you see when they look at other people like, whoa, you better not get love and support and caring another way because it's only this way. And it's like, so yo, true, man. You guys all want the same things.
It's so true. Having said that, if you're religious, like we totally respect it. Like don't get
respect.
It wrong. 110% respect for any religion,
any and all
is welcome in the Zen Dude Fitness community.
Yeah.
But we personally, like I'm just not religious. Amy asks, should I lift weights more or do more cardio if I'm skinny fat and trying to lean out?
Amy, you should lift some weights. I'll tell you why. When you get a little bit more muscle in your body, your resting metabolic rate increases, making it easier for you to get lean.
Jack, what's up, y'all in capitals? What's up, man? What's up? If I'm trying out intermittent fasting, is it okay to down a protein shake during the fast, or does that count as eating?
We get this question all the time.
I do not mean to laugh. It's just funny because
we get this question all the time, and the answer is if it has more than 50 or 60 calories, then you will break your fast. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter if it's a pear or a cucumber or a protein shake or a piece of cake or a cheeseburger or a pizza or a taco
sushi.
Or Thai food
Mexican,
or sushi
African
or a baby cat
curry, baby cats. Guys, the easiest way to think about intermittent fasting is don't think about specific foods. You cannot consume more than 50 calories at all. If it's food, it probably has calories. So you probably don't bet on eating food while you're fasting. That is the answer. Good question, my friend. Tommy asks, I am constantly stepping on my rope when jumping rope. I know how you feel. Did I measure my rope wrong? What exercise should I do to overcome the constant stepping on the rope?
Ooh, first of all, watch the video on how to pick the right jump rope size. We got that on YouTube. Then
that's probably the biggest thing.
Yeah.
Like having the right size jump rope.
Helpful. The second thing is go to the top 5 beginner jump rope mistakes.
Great one.
Because that's one that talks about specifically how to avoid tripping over. And that's the best thing you can do. But that has a better answer than I'll give you right now.
Laura asks, what's different between your old fat melting program? Sorry, don't know the name. Dude, that's fine. I think she's referring to the Getting Lean
program.
Getting
Lean course.
And your new dojo, smiley face.
Yeah, so actually, the Getting Lean course is still available, but the difference is the dojo includes the Getting Lean course, the Gaining Muscle course, and the Accountability Coaching Group. So it has those three things in it, versus the Getting Lean course is just the Getting Lean course.
Correct. Equan, I hope I'm saying your name right, asks, when I'm doing tricks that require weight shifting, aka boxer skip, run place, fast skip, my calf starts to feel a slight pain, but I feel that my form is okay. Is this normal? By the way, it doesn't affect my workout. I can finish all the sets. Good, go.
Man, if you can finish all your sets and doesn't affect your workout, then it's not something I worry about.
Yeah, it's also probably like you just need to get used to doing those moves. And if you're getting any kind of pain, you also might not be hydrated enough. Also check out our How to Prevent Injury video to make sure that you are stretching so you're not getting shin splints and stuff beforehand. Alvin asks, while doing the 4-week challenge, if I miss a day, is it okay to double up on workouts the following day in order to stay on track, or would that be overdoing it?
I would say you could do this once a week, but I wouldn't do it more than once a week.
Yeah.
Really, it's got to be sustainable, right? So if you're constantly like trying to double up or triple up on days, you're going to be like, maybe I don't want to work out today. So in general, try to get your workouts in when you're supposed to get them in.
Also, a strategy I use is like walking. So if I like have a bad day, I'll make sure to go for at least a 4 to 5 mile walk and do my workout. I mean, I walk almost 4 to 5 miles every day, but like I make sure that's me doubling up on a workout. I don't suggest doing two of these workouts. Ron asks, Dan Whitmer, that's me. So everybody knows that the startup of anything, it's hard. Some people said it takes 15 days of doing the same thing to actually make it a habit. What would you recommend to get motivated the first 15 days and create a habit of doing the thing?
Can I answer it? Because he didn't ask me.
No. Dude, yeah. You still get to answer. I'm letting Brandon in on this
Ron, one. Ron, I'm going to answer this as well. And I would say create leverage. This has worked with every like one-on-one coaching client I've worked with in the past, is putting something on the line that says you're going to do it. So if you really are serious about making this lifestyle change, you're going to put $500 on the line and say, if I don't do the thing, I burn this money.
Yeah. Totally agree with Brandon, because I think some habits are, you know, I'd say it's a combination of you need to have leverage. Leverage is such a big thing, guys. And then on top of that, one other thing that we used to do in coaching that Brandon has coached a lot of people on is identity creation. You have to create the identity that doesn't need, you know, that once those strategies have worked for you, then it becomes, you kind of morph into this identity that's like, I'm just going to do this every day because it's who I am now. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Ask the Zen Dudes. Freaking love you guys. One more thing. We're going to Costa Rica for the first Zen Dude Fitness Retreat. That's June 21st through the 25th. All the information about it is down below. Let me give you a short, I'm going to give them a short little detailed description.
Let them know what's up. Let them know what we're doing.
Guys, we're going to be on a beach. There's going to be only 20 of us on a beach in Manuel, San Antonio, Costa Rica, doing beach workouts, hiking,
hugging monkeys,
playing all over the place,
going surfing,
some meditating, some yoga, bro, some Zen dude bowls,
some meditation on the beach, some fresh fish caught that day, every day for your meal.
Woo-wee. Okay, guys, come with us. It's literally 4 to 5 days. It's 4 nights, 5 days of just hanging out with us. You know, we're gonna work out, we're gonna move and stuff, but it's really more about just being there and immersing ourselves, because this community's been growing so strong and most of us have not even met each other yet.
That's crazy.
So, bear hugs. bear hugs coming, watch out.